how long is this going to cook now for?
So this should take another 1 hour, 1 hour 30 minutes. So it all depends on the meat and the quantity, but I think this should be done in say an hour's time.
So this is your kitchen. Feel free to hang out here. I'm going to see you in some time. Yeah?
Action!
So today in my kitchen, I've invited Chef Ansab Khan to teach me how to make an authentic Nali Nihari. Now, Nali Nihari to a Muslim home is what Dal Dhokli is to a Gujarati home. You don't make it every day, you don't wait for a special occasion to make it, you make it on a day when you're craving for something warm and comforting, and Ramadan is one such time. Hello Ansab, what is this asteroid that you've got to the kitchen today?
So firstly, it's not Nihari, but Nahari.
What does Nahari mean now?
So Nahari means morning. Nahar means morning.
So this is not an iftar dish. You eat it as
Sehri? It is something which is eaten as a breakfast. Okay. In Sehri and breakfast, like post-Ramadan also in breakfast.
And how long are we going to... I have a feeling this is an equipment that cooks
this
for
is
hours
something,
and hours.
Obviously. So this is something which I've bought it from Delhi, from Jama Masjid, the place where Nihari originated.
Okay.
So I bought this vessel from there.
Okay. Okay, let's make. Let's cook.
Sure.
First you've got this handi and now you've got these 1000 masalas.
Not 1000, but 15 masalas to make a Nihari masala.
Okay.
So we've got peepli, kebab chini, salt, sauf, starful or badiyan, badi ilaichi, hari ilaichi, dalchini, kali mirch, long, zeera, shah zeera, dhaniya, javitri, jayfal, and make a very fine powder out of it. And you can smell it.
So this is the Nihari masala.
Nahari masala. Yes. So let's begin.
Okay.
So let's start by adding this ghee to the handi or the deg.
All this ghee will go inside.
Yes. Itna. Jaane do. Let it come. Yes. Full. Let it be. Yeah. So now let's add the onions now.
Okay.
To the ghee. Again, few recipes don't add onions as well, but I like to add onion, and this is the way I have learned it from, you know, it's been cooked in my family the way.
So do they have to be super finely chopped or sliced, or how do you like them?
Sliced are fine, mediumly sliced are fine.
Why would you not just add barista at the end for that smokiness?
So barista is added to a korma.
Not to
a nahari.
Okay. So. And a biryani too.
And biryani too, yeah.
What is the whole story that you were telling me about it coming from Delhi?
Delhi, Lucknow, so basically North India is what, you know, different cities claim that Nihari originated, but it's mainly popular in Delhi and Lucknow and UP. So Nihari was something, it was a breakfast food, you know, and especially for the working class.
Okay.
So a pot of meat was kept to cook overnight and it was a nutritious, you know, like a morning breakfast.
Okay.
So wherein people going to work can just like come in, have the curry, roti, and then go off to work.
Okay. So this is during the Mughal period, was it?
Yeah. So late 18th century dish.
Okay. So how long do I have to fry these for?
So the onions are perfectly done now. It's brown now.
Okay.
And now we need to add in our mutton.
Okay.
So just add in the mutton. So basically Nali Nahari is wherein the Nali pieces, there are big chunks of them, and you break those Nali and you take out the, you know, the thing from inside, the marrow.
Okay.
So, and you add that marrow over the curry and the meat is separate.
Okay.
So that's the original Nali Nahari.
So are we attempting to do that?
Not today, so we've only taken Nali ka ghost today rather than doing that way.
Okay.
But if you go to Delhi or any other places and if you ask for Nali Nahari, so they'll take a nali, they'll break that nali, take out the marrow from the nali and put it over your plate of nahari.
Okay.
So now we'll add two bay leaves to it.
Okay. This dish actually requires two human beings to cook it, huh?
Okay, one is enough. And then now we add in the ginger garlic paste. Around 2 tablespoons of ginger garlic paste.
Okay, Ansab, I think this is nicely brown now. Maybe
yes,
you can
looks,
add
looks
spice.
Good.
Danish?
Yes.
Come, you can add the spices.
Yes. So now we'll add Kashmiri mirch, normal mirch, red chili. So Kashmiri mirch is basically for the color, and the other normal mirch will give the spice to it.
So there is degi mirch in there.
Degi mirch. And then there's some haldi.
So when are we adding this 100 spice masala?
15 spice masala. So we'll just add the salt before this.
Okay.
So this has been like bhunong for 5 to 7 minutes around. And now we'll add in the salt. So Sonal, now we can add our
finally
nahari masala.
Finally.
Yes. There it goes in the nahari masala. So mutton is well sorted with the masalas now. As you can see, pura masala all separate ho gaya. It's now almost done. The masala. So now we can add the water to it.
Okay.
So we'll add around 1.5 liters of water.
1.5 liters, okay.
Yes. Because you need to have a good curry along with it, so
okay.
You need plenty of water too. That's it.
What are like some of your favorite Ramzan memories? What do you guys eat at home?
So iftar is basically generally it's more of fruits, but okay. Along with fruit, then there's a lot of like fried stuff. Obviously, keema, samosa, yeah. Kebab, shami kebab.
Okay. And what about sehri? What do you prefer to eat then? Do you always eat nahari?
No, so it's alternate between nahari and keema. Okay. One of them has to be there.
Okay.
And then something like, I like to have some yogurt in sehri, okay. Just to keep it like cool.
So you know the fact that you're a Burmese chef, does that have any influence on your choice of food during this month?
Not greatly, but you know me, like I look out for biryani even in Yangon, so.
You're the biryani so, and nahari yeah. guy.
So, and there is something called Burmese biryani as well, so.
Okay.
But it has some fish sauce in it, so.
That's another episode.
Yeah.
So, how long is this going to cook now for?
So, this should take another 1 hour, 1 hour 30 minutes. So, it all depends on the meat and the quantity, but I think this should be done in, say, an hour's time.
So, this is your kitchen. Feel free to hang out here. I'm going to see you in some time. Yeah? Are we there yet?
About to get done. So one last step is remaining.
What is this?
So this is a slurry of maida with some water.
Okay.
So this will add to the curry. Once the meat is say around 80% cooked.
Okay.
So that's the time when we add it.
So I'm hoping that is 80% cooked.
Yeah, it's around 80% cooked.
Okay.
It's been 1.5 hours since
I left.
Yeah. And so we'll just add the slurry to it. Yes, so you can add a little in a stream and I'll keep stirring. It's very important to stir it well at this time, otherwise there might be lumps in your nihari. At this step, we need to keep checking the consistency. We just cannot go in, you know, all in at once. Once we get the desired consistency.
How do you know what the desired consistency is?
Well, obviously one is experience, but if you follow the recipe as well, you'll get it right, hopefully.
Which is why you must like, yeah. Share and subscribe to our channel and continue following Ansab's recipe to the tea. But then, does it have to be like a soup? Does it have to be like a gravy and mutton? What's the texture that you prefer?
It's got to be little thicker, not very watery.
Thicker than a soup?
Yeah.
Okay. But thinner than a gravy?
Like a little thinner than a korma.
Okay.
So Sonal, finally our nihari is cooked, it's done.
And the kitchen smells fantastic.
So you can look at it. It is perfectly cooked.
It's falling off the bones.
Yes, off the bones. Texture is fine. The rest, you will tell me after tasting it.
This is so good. Thoda tofu dal deti to kya jata?
To ye nihari nahi rehti phir.